Welcome back to Mr. Speller's math tutorials. Today we're given 2 points and we need to find the slope-intercept equation, the y-intercept, and the x-intercept. All right, let's go ahead and get started. We're going to begin by finding the slope, and we see that by saying m is equal to delta y divided by delta x, or the change in y divided by the change in x. The way we show that is to show the difference of the y values divided by the difference of the x values. Let's go ahead and label the points. This is the first point. So let's label it x1, y1. This here's the second point. So let's label that x2 and y2. Well, delta y can be shown as y1 minus y2. And that quantity is divided by x1 minus x2. In this particular example, y1 is 7, and y2 is also 7, so I'm doing 7 minus 7. And for my denominator, x1 is 5, and I'm subtracting off x2, and x2 is negative 8. Let's place that negative 8 in parentheses. So here I have 7 minus 7 to give me 0, and in my denominator I have 5 plus 8, because these two negatives make a positive. So 5 plus 8 to give me 13. So here my numerator is 0, so that's telling me that my slope is 0. Another way you could have figured out the slope is to find the difference of the y and x values, but using the second point first. So that there would be y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So here y2 is the value 7 minus y1, which is also a 7. x2 is negative 8, and subtracting off x1, which is 5. So here again, I have 7 minus 7 to give me 0, and then negative 8 minus 5 to give me negative 13. Again, since my numerator is 0, that makes the entire fraction 0. So here I found my slope to be 0, and this here would be, this here is part A. All right, now let's move on to part B, which is the slope-intercept equation. So here we're gonna start off by using the point-slope formula. So let's go ahead and write this here. So we want the point-slope formula. All right, and with the point-slope formula, we need to use one point and we need to use a slope. For this example here, let's go ahead and use the second point. So I'm gonna write this as the formula is y minus, in this case is gonna be y2 is equal to m times x minus x2. And again, I'm using x2 and y2 because I chose this point. You're probably, more than likely, you're going to see it written as a y1 and a y2, but we're using this point. So let's rewrite using with the substitution. So y minus y2, which is 7, is equal to m. In our case, m is 0. And then we have x minus x2, which is a negative 8. All right, notice here that everything on the right-hand side is being multiplied by 0, so that turns out to be 0. On the left-hand side, we bring down the y minus 7, and then to solve for y, we end up adding 7 to both sides. So this here turns out to be that y is equal to 7, and this here is our equation. It's not in slope-intercept form because it's not a slope-intercept equation. It's actually a horizontal line. So here, but this is the equation we're going to use. The y-intercept, again, we see here is at, it's going to be going through 0.7. So this here is 0, 7. And we're not touching the x-intercept the x-axis at all. So the x-intercept I'm going to label as NA. And now let's go ahead and take a look at this using Desmos. So here we have the 2 points. Point 1 is 5.7. Point 2 is negative 8.7. Let's go ahead and just click on these so that we can show those points. And we found that our equation is going to be y is equal to 7. And here we see we have a horizontal point going through those 2 points. And here we see that our y-intercept is at 0.7 as we showed analytically. All right, well, this sums up this tutorial. If you found it helpful, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, thank you for watching.